tree with fuzzle fuzz and blipper bloops and wuzzle wuzz. Trim up your uncle and your aunt with yards of hoofwatt
blend. Every who down in Whoville liked Christmas a lot, but the Grinch, who lived just north of Whoville, did not. The Grinch hated Christmas, the whole Christmas season. Oh, please don't ask why, no one quite knows the reason. It could be, perhaps, that his shoes were too tight. It could be his head wasn't screwed on just right. But I think that the most likely reason of all may have been that his heart was two sizes too small. But whatever the reason, his heart or his shoes, he stood there on Christmas Eve, hating the Whos. Staring down from his cave with a sour, grinchy frown at the warm, lighted windows below in their town. For he knew every Who down in Whoville beneath was busy now, hanging a holly Who wreath. And they're hanging their stockings. He snarled with a sneer. Tomorrow is Christmas. It's practically here. Then he growled with his Grinch fingers nervously drumming. I must find some way to keep Christmas from coming. For tomorrow, I know, all those Who girls and boys will wake bright and early. They'll rush for their toys and then... Oh, the noise, oh, the noise, 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 noise. There's one thing I hate. Oh, the noise, 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 noise. And the more the Grinch thought of this Who Christmas sing, the more the Grinch thought, I must stop this whole thing. Why, for 53 years I've put up with it now. I must stop Christmas from coming. But how? Then he got an idea. An awful idea. The Grinch got a wonderful, awful idea.
You're a vile one, Mr. Grinch. You have termites in your smile. You have all the tender sweetness of a seasick crocodile, Mr. Grinch. Given the choice between the two of you, I'd take the, seasick crocodile.
Have you been told? Did you ever hear of the curious, furious, fidgety year when Santa Claus unhitched his sleigh and vowed he was taking a holiday? It was long ago, before you were living. Santa got up that morning late, pulled on one boot and then its twin, ruffled the whiskers on his chin, and sat back down on the side of the bed.
Great North Star, but I'm tired,
he said.
Cold in my nose, aches in my fingers and all 10 toes. And a sort of kind of kink inside whenever I think of that Christmas ride.
Now, Santa, you just rest yourself a bit longer. I've already sent for the doctor.
No wonder you got the shivering shakes. Probably never got over the case of near pneumonia you picked up last year gallivanting around the world in your open sleigh. And for what? Just to deliver presents to a bunch of folks who don't give a hoot in the first place.
But,
If you had any sense, you'd give it up as a bad job and stay home in bed this year. Nobody cares about Christmas anymore.
They don't.
Of course not. Nobody cares a hoot and holler for you or Christmas.
Nobody really cares anymore. I better call the boys and tell them to cancel Christmas.
Oh, warn the people. Tell the papers I'm much too tired for Christmas capers.
And the world would soon know that it was to be the year without a Santa Claus. Did you ever hear of that terrible year way back before you were born? When Santa Claus took a holiday on the night before Christmas morn. Well, can you imagine, more or less, what happened when that news reached the press? Headlines screamed, wires went humming. Santa says, too tired, not coming. Out in the stable, nuzzling hay, the reindeer dreamed of Christmas Day. But Santa phoned to the reindeer groom.
Hang up the harness in the big storeroom.
He called to his elves and he told each gnome,
cover up the shelves. We're staying home.
In a last-minute decision, Santa changed his mind and decided to thumb his sniffly nose at mask mandates and health orders. A defiant Santa declared COVID-19 a hoax and said his symptoms were merely part of a regular cold and nothing that herd immunity could not cure. He said he supported David Icke's theory that COVID-19 was in fact a conspiracy by shape-shifting aliens who occupied all major seats of power in the world, and that the plandemic was done in conjunction with Black Lives Matter, Antifa, and other Marxist communists and the radical left as part of an ongoing war on Christmas and an attempt to throw the U.S. election. He, of course, set up a GoFundMe account to pay for what World Health authorities immediately labeled Santa's super spreader agenda. As donations poured in by the millions, Santa got in his sleigh and set flight. But as Santa approached the U.S. flying over the Atlantic Ocean, the reaction was predictable. Here is what happened.
Merry Christmas, everyone. NORAD is tracking Santa Claus's journey down the North Atlantic towards New England on his yearly rounds to give presents to all the boys and girls. He hasn't responded. As per current security regs, we're ordering him to divert to Canada.
Oh, boys, Merry Christmas! Yes, presents down the chimneys! That's what I'm doing! Ho, ho, ho! Ho, ho, ho! Captain Miller's a bad boy! Sorry, Charlie. I'll make it up to you next year.
Mission accomplished, gentlemen. The system works.